For the last 11 years, we have reviewed and collected many My Little Pony items, from plush, vinyl figures, brushables, and minifigures. Unfortunately, we've lost track of what we have, so join us and maybe help us figure out exactly what is in this collection.
Hi everyone, it's John
and Ben,
and the day has come. Something that Ben and I have been talking about for a long, long time. We are about to undertake what may, I don't want to say it's going to be impossible, but Ben, we are going to catalog, we are going to organize our entire MLP collection. We've been collecting slash talking about MLP merch for about 11 years now. Mm-hmm. And how much of this stuff have we cataloged?
None of it.
We don't have a database. And look, we have totes of stuff, bags of stuff, glass vases of stuff, shelves of stuff. We need to organize it all. We need a archive of everything that we have, because it's getting to the point where we're starting to forget what we have.
We got to that point a long time ago, but now it is really starting to get to the point where G4, we don't know exactly what we have, what we thought we did, what we didn't do. You know, we don't know. We don't know anymore. So we need to keep track of everything. I think it is nicely organized.
Yes, you reorganizing all this stuff down here was the inspiration. And originally I was thinking, oh, we'll do like a one-off live stream, mm-hmm, and ask the viewers, like, what was this? Where did this come from? But we quickly realized that this is going to be a more massive undertaking, because we really need a detailed document of everything we have. The plan is, at some point, we're going to put it in a Google Drive. There'll, yes, be a link in the description, yes, so you guys can check out our progress. Mm-hmm.
And if you guys know the answer to whatever question we are asking in that video, you can comment it, or you can check the Google Drive, see if we have
figured it out
or not. And you guys can help us keep everything all tracked.
People are going to give us links to videos of us talking about what we don't remember.
That's fine. Maybe we can have a column for links of the videos.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Then you can go back and watch it if you can't find it, because YouTube search is weird.
Yeah, I asked Ben if she was going to take a picture of everything, each item, for this database project, and she said
no.
In this document, I foresee it having, like, the character, the series, the company that made it, possibly if we can remember the year it came out, mm-hmm, and where it's located in our collection.
Right.
We are going to be going shelf by shelf, tote by tote, figuring out what we have. Couple disclaimers here. We have not saved everything over the past 11 years. Some stuff has got lost or misplaced.
We had to clean out the collection a little bit, because some of the stuff, like Comable Ponies or Equestria Girls, they came out with so many of them that we just had too many. So we had to send them to a new home.
We sold a lot of them.
Yes.
In particular, Equestria Girls, like Ben said, it got to the point where we had like a dozen Pinkie Pies, a dozen Twilights, mm-hmm, just the only difference being, for the most part, they had a different set of clothes on.
Yeah, different outfit.
And the other thing we really pared down over the years were the fashion styles, where we had a couple samples here. They had to be really unique, like Pinky's Boutique, or characters that weren't really available in any other form, like Daring Do,
yeah,
for us to save them. But Fashion Style and Equestria Girls, we still have a lot of them, but not as many as we did at one point in time. Oh, this is going to be quite the journey, guys. It's also going to be fun. It's going to be like a trip down memory lane for us, mm-hmm, and hopefully for you guys.
Yeah.
Because like every time I turn around, it's like, oh, remember Squishy Pops?
Our love-hate relationship for Squishy Pop.
Another thing we never really did was organize the accessories, especially for the first 5 or 6 years. Ben, in more recent years, says after we open something, puts all the accessories in a little Ziploc bag.
Yeah.
And writes on it what it came with, but yeah, I don't know if I'd be able to open this without knocking a bunch of stuff over, but that is just a small sample of unorganized MLP accessories. We're going to figure out what they went with, maybe. Hey, remember a few minutes ago when Ben said we got rid of a lot of combable ponies? Look at this. This tote is filled with just combable ponies. Is this one all Twilight? Whoops, all Twilights. Oh man, what are we getting ourselves into? We should have done this back in 2020.
We should have, yes. But that's when I started putting this room together.
That's true.
This room was a complete disaster. You couldn't even walk past our filming table without having to move stuff out of the way. And as context, that door is how you get in here. And the filming table is right next to it. So we couldn't get in here. It was a mess. There was trash. There was boxes of stuff. And I spent probably 2 weeks straight just working in this room to get things up on shelves, to get it all cleaned out, and to get it all organized.
And that's what gave us the inspiration to tackle this. So let's just do it. We're going to have to start somewhere. So we're going to have to figure out a numbering system for each shelf. Mm-hmm. Like this could be shelf A.
Right.
A1 is the top. A2, A3, A4. What are all those Disney guys doing down there? They don't belong here.
They need a new home.
So this is an authentic Toys R Us My Little Pony the Movie display sign. You know, back in the day at Toys R Us, this would be over an aisle like this. And on the other side, I guess this would be for an end cap, maybe. So yeah, we bought this fairly recently, and it wasn't very expensive at all.
It's way bigger than we thought it was going to be.
I was actually picturing in my head more like something like this.
I was thinking it was going to be narrower, like not as tall.
So by the end of this series, we're going to find a place to hang it.
I don't know where. I'm thinking,
it's been a long time since all these have been out of that vase. Don't you want to jump in them like Uncle Scrooge?
I know. That's only half of our...
I know. This isn't even a fraction of the blind bag ponies we've accumulated. But I pulled out this one. It's like a G1 pony in mini size.
You don't belong in that vase. You belong over here. I was putting it on the shelf with the rest of the little mini ponies. There's a double. There's the same one right next to it.
Where did we even get those?
I don't know.
Ben, I can't wait for the part of this series where you catalog all these blind bag ponies by series. If you or anyone you know ever sent Ben and I a mini pony, rest assured, we saved every single one.
Yep. How did all of these fit in that jar?
I wouldn't want to say we have one of the biggest collections of G4 merch, because I'm sure there are other people who put us to shame. So this is currently our G5 collection. And you know it is going to outgrow these two little shelves very quickly. Maybe we should start cataloging the G5 ones first. That might be a little more manageable. So the day has come. We're going to add the very first items to our My Little Pony database spreadsheet. So we decided we're going to be starting with the top row. So this unit is going to be shelf 1. Then we'll have 1A, 1B, 1C. Oh boy, I'm not looking forward to this one. Blind bags may be waiting till last. Mini ponies, we may be putting a pin in that one. We have the Rainbow Rots Equestria Girls. The first item in the first line of the database will be going to be this Twilight right here, Rainbow Rocks.
Of course.
Do you remember these? Do you remember these pen Equestria Girls?
Yes.
See, they're pens. I'm sure there were multiple Twilights for Rainbow Rocks.
Yeah, which one is this?
Maybe it's just a standard one. I don't know. But yeah, the whole main six is here on the stage. The stage playset.
Tell me the names that we have.
We have Twilight, Rainbow Dash, Pinky, Fluttershy, Rarity, Applejack. And they're all here on the main stage. I have the Twilight pen here because I wanted to see what the base says. This says Canal Toys. And these pens came out in 2014, if the copyright information on the base is to be believed.
2014. All right.
Okay, beside the stage on this top shelf, first shelf in the inventory, we have Rainbow Rocks Trixie.
Okay.
And we also have Octavia. She was one of those sets that came with both doll and pony. How are we gonna do that? You could classify as brushable, and then in the miscellaneous section, like you said, you could put in what she came with.
Well, I was just gonna put Octavia Equestria Girl, and then in the accessories have the pony.
Yeah, but what if we need to look up the pony on its own?
So we'd have to enter it twice?
Well, yeah, we could have Equestria Girl Octavia, and then Pony Octavia. In the back from the MLP movie, we have the Singing Songbird Serenade. This was a Target exclusive, and you can kind of make her out back there. I was pressing the button earlier.
Okay, and she's a fashion style, right?
Yeah, she's like a fashion style size, but yeah, she has a little sound feature. We have this Twilight Sparkle ball of unknown origin. Where did this come from?
I don't know. What do I even call that, a ball?
This had to have come in some Easter basket or something. It says copyright 2021 Hasbro, licensed by Hasbro, distributed by Mega Toys. All one word. And that's it for shelf 1A, the tippity top of the shelf. Should I just go across? We have a few more Rainbow Rocks on this shelf as well. We got, let's see if I remember their names. Adagio Dazzle. And what were her two friends' names? Aria and, I don't know. I wonder if she still works. Didn't you push your arm down, or is it this arm?
I think you go up, right? I think her arm goes up.
Still works. Sonata and Aria, right?
I think you are correct.
Sonata and Aria.
Aria Blaze and Sonata Dusk.
I believe, yeah, these two came together.
Yes, they did.
In a two-pack.
Yep.
Also up here we have, I'll just get the rest of the Rainbow Rocks out of the way.
Yep.
We have Sunset, and we have the two princesses. We got Luna and Celestia. Each rocking out on the mics over here.
I don't know if they're actually called princess in this line, but we'll...
Just to make things easier.
Yeah.
Just for future reference, we'll still refer to them as princesses. I guess, wouldn't she be principal?
Principal Celestia.
Who also plays in the rock band on the side.
Right, why not?
Oh, we got another Twilight over here hiding... I think that's a through the mirror one. I think she's another talking one.
Yes, she is. Yeah.
I'll probably knock 20 things over, but I gotta see if she still works after all these years.
I'm Twilight Sparkle.
I'm Twilight Sparkle. Who remembers that? Is this from the movie? No, I guess it's just Friendship is Magic, but it's movie era. Let me move. Her wings are huge. We got this Princess Celestia Glitter and Glow. And of course, gotta test it. Gotta test it. Oh, she's still glittering and glowing.
Wings move. I should put that in there. The wings move.
Flapping wings.
I'm trying to put in characteristics of them so that...
Flappy wings.
Yeah, so that they're easier to figure out who they are later.
She must have been a deluxe one.
Yeah.
So in the back, we have the Amazon exclusive Twilight as Star Swirl the Bearded with Spike in his little dragon costume.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what the technical title of the item was.
I don't either.
But they came packaged in this book. We reviewed this fairly recently, but in my mind, fairly recently is like 2020.
Yeah, right? What's next?
Next up, we have a brushable Twilight inside a train engine.
Okay.
See?
Okay.
This could have been part of a larger playset that we have lost over time.
Yeah.
I'll be glad when this shelf's over with, because I've knocked over these microphones about 10 times. And then the last item on this top shelf here, this would be shelf 2A, are the four My Little Pony Potato Head Happy Meal toys. You'll have to name this one, taking it from the top. Oh, man. We got the talking princesses. You know I'm going to have to hit every button. So we got Power Ponies up here. We got Fashion Style Power Ponies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We got all 6 of them. I know Rainbow Dash was Zap. She was like Power Ranger or something. Oh man, I used to know all of these. Anyway, we got the Toys R Us. I remember this one. Remember the Toys R Us line where they were all tattooed with flowers?
Mm-hmm. My barrettes look so pretty.
Still works. Batteries haven't corroded yet. That's something we'll have to do someday. Take the batteries out of these before they explode. We saw what happened to Walkin' Iron Man.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh no, we also have like Enterplay lunchboxes back here.
Okay, go stick one thing at a time.
I'm overwhelmed. I thought this would be fun. It's stressing me out.
What talking princesses do we have?
Okay, we have this like Flower Power Celestia. I believe this is Cadence.
Looks like Cadence.
Well, I remember some of the early MLP merch. Remember Celestia was pink as well? Yeah, yeah. But I do believe this is Wedding's
Wedding Cadence.
Then we also have Nightmare Moon and Queen Chrysalis up here. Ben, hit the button to see if Cadence still works after all these years. People would be disappointed if I didn't hit every button. I wonder if she'll say it like, my barrettes look amazing.
One day, all of Equestria will bow to me. I am Queen Chrysalis, ruler of the changelings. Brush my hair, my dear minion.
I forgot that one was pretty good.
Your love makes me even more powerful.
For the most part, they're all in character.
Yep.
But for some reason, just that barrette line that she hasn't said yet.
I can feel my magic getting stronger. Behold the power of the Changeling Queen.
Was it a different one that said it?
Fly through the night. I am Nightmare Moon. Do you recall my legend?
I think they reused the same laugh. Maybe I'm thinking of a different toy. Maybe it wasn't this Chrysalis that said...
Was it Nightmare Moon?
I don't know. I've been pressing her button too. Neither one of them said, my barrettes look amazing.
One of them said it.
You know, I think we gave this one... too much of a hard time, because I like the line where she goes, brush my hair, my minion.
I agree.
Oh, man. So in the back here, I see an Enterplay lunchbox tin, the rarity one. I don't know if we're storing anything in that tin. I don't dare reach that far back.
No, I don't think there's anything in them.
Maybe the poster that came with them, perhaps?
Yeah.
And then over here, I think this is a puzzle. This Crystal Empire lunchbox. I think a puzzle came in there. I was daring and took the lunchbox tin off the shelf. I don't think this was an Enterplay, though. 2013. Yep, it was a puzzle. Who made it? I don't know. More research is necessary. I was looking for, like, some fine print or something. All I have is copyright Hasbro.
I don't even remember putting it together.
Somebody in the comments will say, Ben, you put that puzzle together in 2014, don't you remember? Well, that's why we're doing this video series,
I'll
guys.
Have the video link on the screen.
Yeah. So this Chicken Pinkie Pie exclusive, the back of the package is right there. That's like the covering, because when it's all together, it looks like a bucket of like Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Yeah.
Which is very clever. I think this was peak Hasbro package design here.
Yeah.
Okay, and wrapping up the shelf, we have... We have a couple things. We have a couple hot air balloons in the back.
Okay.
They were different in some way, I think.
The color is different, I think.
I think one is like the original Twilight balloon that came out, and another one, I think Rarity came with it in like a Kohl's exclusive.
I think so.
And in the front we have like this is a Toys R Us exclusive, this little carousel.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the Carousel Boutique. What they did was they recycled like a G3 playset.
Yeah.
It looks like it came with a Pinky and a Rarity. I think it came out with the Friendship Festival stuff at Toys R Us.
Mm-hmm.
So it was the movie-style ponies, but with a G3 playset that nobody could really fit into. And then we also have these little combable Fluttershy and Rainbow Dash. Do they all come together?
No.
They're in like in these little bumper car things.
I think those are two separate sets.
Sets from the same era.
Yeah.
And there we go. That is going to wrap up shelf 3A. Now this shelf over here has a bunch of interesting things. Mostly the Play School ponies, which are still adorable. We got Pinky and we got Twilight and they're molded into little cars. Oh, I guess we can take them out of their little cars. There were actually some of these we never got. I think there was a Spike in this style. Oh, we have Rainbow Dash in a car too over here.
Play School?
Yep, these are the Play School ponies. Oh man, I can't tell what's in the back of this. Guys, can you tell what's in the back here? It looks like a Rarity boutique of some sort. Am I right? I can't really tell. So I don't know what their names are. We have a pony with bumblebees, white pony with pink hair, and a watermelon for a cutie mark, like a half a moon-shaped watermelon. Then we have Rainbow Dash. We got Pinky. We got Cheerilee. We got Minty. We got... Somebody's yelling at the screen right now. So this is like, what would you say, like a lavender pony? With pink and white hair and a star for a cutie mark. Did you get the bumblebee one in your spreadsheet?
Yeah.
And this other one, Daisy Dreams, maybe? Has a daisy for a cutie mark. Purple pony. And of course we have the big playset that they came with. Now these are a real blast from the past. These were some of the very earliest MLP videos we ever posted. The designer ponies. And Ben really went crazy customizing these.
I did. I had a lot of fun doing those.
She turned a Rainbow Dash into a Derpy. This was before there was a lot of official Derpy merch.
Mm-hmm.
And this was transforming a Princess Luna into a Cadence.
Yeah.
Because we had a theory that it was supposed to be a Cadence originally.
Yes.
But for whatever reason, they turned it into a Luna.
Right.
Was this like a Shadow Bolt?
I think so, yeah.
And in the back from Equestria Girls, we have Sunset Shimmer's motorbike. We have DJ's car with the sunglasses for a windshield. All right, it's killing me. I got to see what's in the back there. Okay, so it was a Rarities boutique. It was like one of those on-the-go carry case ones. Oh yeah, I remember this with like the paper foldouts in the middle. Don't remember what it was called officially, but I do remember opening that. So there's something else back there too. There's something else behind the Play School ponies. What is it? What is it? Oh, we got a carriage of some sort. A purple carriage. And, oh, it's like a school bus. It's like a school bus for the mini ponies.
Okay.
I have vague memories of that, but you can kind of see it through there. No idea where the carriage came from. Must have been with a Princess Twilight, if I had to guess. Ben's tapping away furiously. Yep, they have Hasbro. Copyright 2012 on the hoof. And the hoof marking for MLP. Blast from the past, guys. Do you think anybody's going to watch this series?
I don't know.
I'm having fun. And then, I don't know, this is like overflow, some miscellaneous stuff.
Yeah.
For completeness' sake, this is the Rainbow Dash. This is a Yahtzee game, the Yahtzee. Dice game.
Yep.
This is kind of spilling over onto Disney shelves.
Yeah, maybe we can fix that later.
This was a bubble blower. I remember now.
Yeah.
I remember we made a mess with it, I remember correctly. So here's a Pinkie Pie bubble blower. Her face like lifts up and bubbles come out of her neck. This is a baseball hat. Maybe a fan sent this to us. I don't know. With Twilight on it.
I don't think we need to categorize that, do we?
We need it for completeness' sake, Ben. Twilight hat that is too small for anybody's head. Here's a ceramic piggy bank. Walmart used to sell these.
Yeah.
We have Pinky, probably the same company that made one of my all-time favorite pieces of merch, the Twilight Sparkle Pig piggy bank.
Yeah.
I've told Ben I want a display shelf of ponies shaped like other things, or just weird things, like these cubed ponies, which are like...
Those are fidgets.
Yeah, these were Hasbro capitalizing on the fidget craze like 5 years after it was dead.
Yep.
Making a comeback now, so maybe they could have done it, but we have these like little cubed Twilight and Rainbow Dash. And what was in this little tin originally?
Candy.
So the ceramic Pinkie Pie bank is imported by Fab, F-A-B, Starpoint, New York, New York. That little chocolate tin reminded me of, I remember a fan sent us the Rainbow Dash energy drink.
Yeah.
We still have the empty can, the fizzy cherry something. But we still have the can in there. We will document it more in a future video. I'm pretty sure Hasbro themselves made these fidgets. Who made... this Pinkie Pie. Ben, do a Pinkie Pie voice as I make her talk.
I can't talk out of here. That's my neck, not my mouth.
Okay, this says copyright 2010 Hasbro.
Wow.
Imperial Toys.
Okay.
All right.
Who made Yahtzee? Was that Hasbro? Is Yahtzee a Hasbro toy?
It's gotta be through one of their subsidiaries, just like Play School. They own Play School.
Yeah.
If you're a hardcore collector and wondering where this came from, this is the top of the Aurora plush spinner display.
Yeah.
This would sit on the top of the spinner rack to let everybody know, hey, this gift shop has My Little Pony plushes. So if you see that bumping around as I was looking at the top shelf, that's where that came from. This series is going to take forever, but we knew it would, because especially if we stop and reminisce over every single item. So stay tuned. We're going to be moving down to another set of shelves shortly. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you can help us out identifying anything, let us know down in the comments.
We'll add all of your details into our spreadsheet.
Yes, we will. Oh no, Ben, add the rewinding sound effect, because out the corner of my eye, I went in the other room to get a tissue and I came back. Rainbow Dash's airship
from the
movie.
Yep.
It was a Guardians of Harmony, but also the movie. This was a Walmart exclusive. This giant airship. I don't dare try to get it out, but of course everybody remembers this. Almost missed it. Did you hide anything else back there, Ben?
I don't know.
Okay, now it is your turn. You need to help us fill in the blanks. The link to the Google Doc that shows everything that we have so far in our collection is listed down below. So go in there, check it out, see what we're missing, help us fill in all of our blanks, and we'll see you guys next time when we figure out what is in this collection.